happy, happy Christmas celebration to you, our esteemed viewers, everyone out there. Happy Christmas and wishing you a prosperous new year. My name is Margaret Opara and have with me.
And I'm Frank Omalape. Thank you for joining us. Of course, this is the Christmas edition or special or coming to you from Ibrand Studio live here. Of course, it's a way of welcoming you to Christmas.
It's Christmas season, and I could just imagine, Frank, you're wearing red, and I'm so wearing red. It's like the spirit
of course,
Christmas.
You should know that.
And
that
it's beautiful, right?
It's a period of sharing love, and what that means is that you can always give back to society, either by way of giving out gifts, physical gifts, or you give out clothes. But this call, of course, this call, of course, stands for love, it stands for emotion. Yeah. Of course, color red is for emotion. And it's a time where we're rejoicing that, someone was born.
And another thing is the Christ and the Mass. Now, people say Xmas, but I think the X should be taking out. It's Christmas, so if you say Xmas, you're taking out the main reason for the celebration. Christ is the reason for the celebration.
I think that's a very good understanding, but people do not understand that. Yeah. Okay, it's not Xmas, but it has to be Christmas.
Yeah, because there's a reason for the Mass. That's Christ is the reason for the season. Whatever you do, make sure you give out love, because Christ was an epitome, or is an epitome of love, you know. Well, meanwhile, Frank, during the live band presentation, I could see you moving your body, and you were almost getting up to dance.
Of course, it's a special way, or our own special way of welcoming, you know, the viewers to this special edition of the program.
Yeah.
And of course, we cannot but start with Thanksgiving.
Correct.
Because this is a time where we should be celebrating. Mm. Why? Not just because we're celebrating the birth of Christ alone, but it's a time where people give thanks to God. It's a time where people appreciate God for keeping alive from January to now. So it's a time to really celebrate.
Wow.
And that's the best way we can start this program.
Ah, correct. All right, still in the mode of celebration right now. Don't forget, it's a Christmas edition. And like Frank rightly said, do well to give out love, show love, and after the show, you can feel free to call me for lunch in your house, or Frank, one of you will be available for lunch.
Of course, like I said earlier, that it's a time to give.
All
and
right.
So, of course, it will be nice to have you come over and maybe share love together. Over a dinner, over a lunch or over a breakfast, as it were.
All right. I do, before we go into the next segment of the day, we'll take a very, very short time, but now we'll be right back for more interesting segments. Welcome back, and now it's time for the show flow of the day. And now I'm having me my amazing co-host,
of course, just to let you know that this is Ibrand Christmas special. It's a special program that we'll bring into you. Expect a whole lot to come over to your screen right now. But like I said earlier, the show is packed full of excitement, a lot of things to expect on the program. But the first one that will be coming to you, of course, expect news update. There are news trending during this Yuletide period, a lot of messages, goodwill messages will be pouring in from our political office holders and leaders. Expect also, of course, interview with the some clerics who will be telling us the essence of the Christmas or essence of the season, because a lot of us do not really know why we're celebrating Christmas.
Yeah.
I think it will be time, or it will be nice to have someone tell us why we're celebrating as well. Also to expect, of course, is the business segment. We cannot talk at Ibrand television. We cannot talk about any other thing without also mentioning business. So everything on Ibrand is business for us as well. Entertainment and sport update will be coming your way as well. Also expect social media trends for those of you who cannot wait for some trending stories.
As usual.
Of course.
Yeah.
And when you talk about the millennials, well, you find them trending on social media. And that's where you find them. So you also have a birthday shout out. Expect that as well. And well, we stop the band from playing earlier, but we're going to be doing that.
And trust me,
I mean, enough extensively.
You don't want to miss
dance
that.
Is going to be dance or celebration on the program. So it's iBrand TV Christmas special. But we'll take a break now. When we come back, of course, it'll be time to take you through some of the news updates that we have for you on the program today. Please stay with us.
My name is Agogo Ayanago. We are on the streets of Lagos to check out something incredible. It is the holiday season, a season where people come together, families meet together. There are a lot of travels, a lot of celebration because it's a season of peace, a season of joy, a season of laughter, and the most important, a season of decorations. To me, I love decorations. I don't know about you. So I went around the streets of Lagos looking for decorations and I found one right behind me. Isn't that very spectacular? See, these decorations always mark this season, and I want to find out what people think about the decorations. I do love them, but I don't know about any other person. Let's go talk to some people.
The holiday season is here again, and it is one of love, peace, and joy. And all around the world, people celebrate with family and friends. One thing that makes it different from other holidays is the decorations. Over the years, Christmas decorations have become bigger, spectacular, more creative and fun than the last. From London to the United States, from Mexico to Australia, decorations beautify everywhere. Nigeria is not left out as we see spectacular decorations along streets, adorning buildings and some major historical places. We asked people their opinions about Christmas decorations and here are some responses.
Based on the decoration, this one is very nice. I like the Father Christmas they use on this. Why this one also, they are all nice.
It's a special moment to share your love and thought, special moment with your family. Decoration is what makes everyone happy, especially during the Christmas period. You tend to, you know, to see different designs, and also it's an artistic work from different people.
Like what I'm seeing right here is a wonderful place to be, wonderful place to snap, you know. It makes this place look like in New York, you know. It's like heaven on earth. I get to this, and I love it. I love what I'm seeing, and I feel like snapping.
They bring so much life to the environment, so much color to the season, you know, and of course, so much joy, so much active nightlife everywhere. It's a beautiful scene to behold every year.
The whole place looks so amazing, yeah, because it is a special season, you know. So this has been happening for more than a decade now. Every year, when you come here, by this time you notice that everything is beautiful.
The decorations is nice, like shows the spirit of Christmas, like that feeling, you know, that feeling. This one rhymes with this feeling of Christmas. So smelling everywhere, in fact, it's really lovely.
A lot of people are coming here from far distance, so for the fun. Some people will come to the come from another state, understand? So to for the preparations of Christmas celebration.
The decoration is quite beautiful. You know, we love, I'm a Christian by the way, we love celebrating Christmas. It's the birth of our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. And you know, we love celebrating a great festival like this.
From the opinions heard, we can see that besides making a place beautiful, these decorations bring a feeling of joy to the heart. So we see joy to the world through our decorations.
Thank you.
Glad to have you join us right here on iBrand Special Christmas Edition. Now it's time for Perpetua to join us for the news update. Perpetua is right here in the studio. Hello, Perpetua.
Hi. Hello and welcome to the news update. My name is Perpetua Fasanripita. Now the news. The federal government has declared Monday 27th, Tuesday 28th December 2021 and Monday 3rd January 2022 as public holidays to mark Christmas, Boxing Day and New Year's Day celebrations respectively. The Minister of Interior, Rauf Aregbesola, made the declaration on behalf of the federal government, felicitating with Christians and all Nigerians at home and in the diaspora on this year's Christmas and New Year celebrations. In a statement signed by the Permanent Secretary of the Minister of Interior, Shuaib Belgore, the minister was quoted as saying, "We must emulate the life of Jesus Christ in his practice and teachings on humility, service, compassion, patience, peace and righteousness that his birth signifies. This will be the best way to portray Christ and celebrate his birth," end of quote. He stressed that peace and security are two critical conditions for economic development and prosperity and urged Christians and Nigerians to make the best use of this festive period to pray for the total eradication of insecurity bedeviling our dear nation, Nigeria. The Christian Association of Nigeria, CAN, has asked Nigerian leaders to use their powers to bring relief and joy to Nigerians this Christmas. President of CAN, Reverend Dr. Samson Shukbo Ayokunle, in a statement, urged those in place of authority to lessen the pains of Nigerians by paying more attention to their well-being, by promptly paying workers' salaries and pensions to the pensioners. The CAN president also urged Nigerians to observe COVID-19 health protocols during the Christmas season, encouraging citizens not to let down their guards, especially as the country has entered the fourth phase of the pandemic. The Holy Father, Pope Francis, has felicitated with Christians all over the world on Christmas. In a message on his verified Twitter page, the Pope harped on humility as the mystery of Christmas. In his words, "Let us allow ourselves to be evangelized by the humility of Christmas, of the manger, of the poverty and simplicity with which the Son of God entered the world. Let us allow ourselves to be evangelized by the humility of the child, Jesus. This is the lesson of Christmas. Humility is the great condition for faith, for the spiritual life, and for holiness. May the Lord grant it to us as a gift," end of quote. And that's all on the news update at this hour. Thank you for joining us. I am Perpetua Fasanripita. And of course, I'm not alone. I'm in the studio with Margaret and Frank. It feels so good to share this studio with you.
You look like a Miss Nigerian now.
Oh, you can say that again. I'm a Nigerian, yes, and blue, white, red, these are the colors of Christmas. I decided, why not represent your country? I'm a proud Nigerian.
I think green isn't part of Nigerian.
I'm glad that you're just... for that spirit of patriotism, just superb at this time. You talk about Christmas, but you just went straight and talk about Nigeria, and that shows how much you love Nigeria. I love you for that.
You can say that.
So yeah. I love you for that.
Especially it's Christmas Day, so what are we coming up for dinner, lunch,
Whatever you want. I'm available after the show. You can come around.
There's one part of the news that I was going to talk about, which is the big news for everyone. Public holiday, second and third. And it's a long holiday. Look at Saturday, look at Sunday, which is weekend, of course, of Christmas Day.
Correct,
and then you look at Monday and look at Tuesday again.
Okay.
I mean, a very long holiday for most Nigerians you know, some of them, if I trust Nigeria, they know how to work. Work is all about work. And when they want to catch fun, they know how to catch fun.
Definitely.
And so, of course, this long holiday will afford everyone for that long.
Everyone? Are you sure? Everyone?
Oh, yes,
exactly.
Everyone.
I was going to come there.
Are you going to have fun?
Hold on a minute. Okay. Our own work is special. Of course, of course.
But then that's
Given the virtue of our profession, of course, it's special. But in a way, it's still a way to relax. Because even if you're at work, there's still a way to relax.
Oh, really?
Well, you can say that again. And then for me, I would say that I took interest in the message from the Minister of Interior, that's Rauf Arebeshola, talking about peace and security, saying that these things are important for economic development. And then, you know, I remember we... I would say that looking at what's going on now, you would see that the fanfare and all of that isn't really in the air. Mm. And you can tell that there are so many things that are responsible for
this. The excitement is low.
The excitement isn't like what it used to be. Mm. But then it's our hope that, you know, people will just forget about whatever challenge it is and just use this period to probably rest. Like you said, you know, we have 4 days to rest. And apart from that, you can actually do other things. Just I would like to say to people that you should take your mind away from a lot of the challenges, because when you look at the number of people that are traveling, I can tell you for a fact that that has kind of reduced. That's one. And there are so many reasons for that. For crying out loud, if you want to travel, you want to be sure that you're safe. You're looking at the fact that if you want to go to the east now, you're scared. You don't know what's going to happen in the east. You want to go to the north, you don't know what's going to happen. There have been news of kidnappings, a whole bus, you know, being the people in a bus being kidnapped. And all these are things you hear, and you don't want to travel. You just want to stay where you are. And these are things I do not want to continue. I want a Christmas where people can be free to travel. And so when I saw that message from Ogbeni Rauf Arebeshola, I felt like, okay, this shouldn't be our Christmas.
But then just add to what he said, he also, one of the messages he sent out was the fact that people should emulate the humility, the life of Christ. Now, looking at the life of Christ, for Christians, even for Muslims, we'll know the life of Christ. You could tell that this man is a man who wanted the good of everybody, who was moved by, he had compassion, he was peaceful, he gave, he forgave. So if really people, you emulate the life of Christ, you would see that all of those things in the society that people still kill, try to do some certain things that are not, that shouldn't even be heard of, by emulating the life of Christ, it reduces it to the barest minimum. I think that was it for me, because imagine you emulate the life of Christ and you try to live like him. I do so, Frank does so, everybody in the world tries to do so. Trust me, how many people would kill? How many people would steal? How many people would want to...
Nobody, want to, if you ask me. If everyone does that...
For any reason, at least for the sake of this season, Yuletide and celebration, a time of love, laughter, and sharing of love, I think... I think it would be worth it.
Definitely. Yes. Finally,
it would be worth it.
Okay, I think finally, I would just like to say, it doesn't matter what you're experiencing right now. It doesn't matter what it is, what's happening out there. The most important thing is that you are alive. I mean, if we start counting reasons why we probably should complain, not feel good. I mean, there's so many. But hey, beyond all of those things, the fact that I am alive today, I'm breathing, and I have people in my life that are amazing. I have Margaret as a friend. I have Frank as a colleague. I've got some friends. I've got family members. I think it's enough to just look at your mom, look at your wife, look at your husband, look at your daughter, smile and say, thank you, I have this gift.
All right.
I think so.
Yeah, if we go on.
Thank you so much, Perpetual, for the news of the day.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Perpetual.
All right, bye for now.
All right, that was Perpetual Ryan, the studio with us. So we'll take a first commercial break right now. When we come back, trust me, there are a lot of packages awaiting you on this beautiful Christmas day. We'll be right back.
You go enter market, just make you go buy fresh palm fruits. When you reach house, you go wash, you go pound. Your body gonna pay you, even your fingernails gonna pay you. But make una no worry, make una relax. I get good news for now. Una don't hear Banga fresh palm fruit extract. All you need to do now make you go for the up, open now. Take the amount where you want, put them for your pot. Which soup will you want to make? Shina egusi, shina ogbono, shina vegetable, shina banga. My sister no waste time again. My brother no waste time again. Just go buy Banga fresh palm fruit extract. The gunu say you sabi cook and you be better cook.
Banga, come make your food yum yum.
Distributors needed nationwide. Phone number 081-6397-4447. 08035644436 07066638213. Banga Fresh Palm Fruit Extract.
The 25th of December every year has been set aside as Christmas Day for Christians all around the globe to mark the birth of Jesus Christ. Christmas season in Nigeria is characterized by decorations and carols in anticipation not only by Christians but by all. Christmas means different things to different people. To some people, it's the season of reverence, while some others see it as a time to show love.
It is the celebration of the child that is being born to us to come and redeem us back to our first love and to God.
Christmas means a lot to me, and Christmas is a celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ. And Jesus is the reason for the season.
Christmas means a lot to me because it has to do with the celebration of Jesus Christ. Practically, I don't really know much, but I know it's about Jesus Christ. Yeah.
Christmas is all about love. It's all about sharing God's love to others. It's all about giving and sharing, not being stingy or selfish, you know.
For some, it's a period of sober reflection.
It's love embodiment, love in totality. So Christmas for me is when you show love to one another, and to an extent, we Nigeria take it to the extreme by traveling to our various hometowns to see loved ones, to see family, to see friends you've not seen for a very long time.
Christ was given for us. In Isaiah 9:6, he said, a child was given unto us. As above all, he is the Prince of Peace.
Time to remember the birth and the death of our Lord Jesus Christ.
It's not a do or die something that you must buy ram, cow, or you spend extravagantly for just Christmas.
The question is, what does Christmas mean to you? Chioma Amaribulam, reporting for iBrand TV.
Christmas in Nigeria is at once both a religious and cultural celebration. It is a huge celebration for all citizens, not only those who belong to the Christian faith. The celebration receives substantial influence and coloration from the indisputable Nigerian spirit. So much so that individuals begin to make plans for celebrating Christmas as early as the last week of October. Christmas is definitely a big deal in Nigeria. Christmas in Nigeria brings out the very best of the country while making it a place to enjoy the thrill of the Christmas carnival. However, some certain customs are unique and are now associated with Nigerians. Let's relive those nostalgic Christmas memories and go down memory lane. What is a Christmas celebration without your big pot of jollof rice served with a big piece of chicken and other extras such as moi moi, salad, plantain, and so on? Everyone looks forward to that Christmas rice. It is a special delicacy. Christmas chicken or turkey has to accompany the Christmas rice, and many families kill their chicken themselves. Some go through the whole process of choosing the chicken, choosing which one to kill, who to kill it, the feather it, chopping up, which creates a bonding time for the family. Now let's examine the Santa, popularly known as Santa from North Pole, but in this part of the world, he is known as Father Christmas. We got to sit on Father Christmas's laps and receive the best gifts during our childhood. In Nigeria, Father Christmas doesn't sneak into your home. Instead, children are taken to see him at any of the locations where he's stationed. Regards Christmas clothes, the anticipation of getting a new outfit for Christmas was thrilling. It was a tradition admiring your new outfit along with your friends on Christmas Day, and it was a feeling that was so extra pretty in itself. New clothes, shining Christmas shoes with matching glasses, and colorful toy wristwatches. This is definitely a big deal for children. Sharing food with neighbors was also one anticipated moment for young ones, especially as they'll be expecting cash tokens in return. If there was a time to make money as a child, it was definitely Christmas. Another delightful memory was traveling to the village and celebrating with family members whom we haven't seen for so long. Playing outdoor games with loved ones and singing Christmas carols was also the peak of it. Or should I talk about bangas, also known as knockouts or fireworks? It was always a norm to hear the sounds of knockouts around the neighborhood. Firecrackers were a way of ushering us into the Christmas season. Can you remember the banga street competitions? Everyone wanted to be on the winning team. It felt like living on the edge. You did not know where the next bangas were coming from. Firecrackers are definitely a big deal in Nigeria during festive periods. Within every 3-minute walking distance, a firecracker vendor can be found during the festive season. There were also the Christmas sparkles, also known as disco light, or in the Yoruba language, in Ilorin. Regards carol services, many organizations, schools, and churches organized carol services, and it accompanied singing, dancing, and as always, food. Decorating the Christmas tree and around the house is also a favorite for all ages. It adds to the Christmas spirit and cheers, especially with the Christmas songs that play along, and some children do as far as making paper decorations. Christmas in Nigeria is an escape from the cold bleakness of winter snow to the rich heritage of African tradition. Nigeria, with its traditions, glamour, and extravaganza. Can we say Christmas is a time to spend money and forget January is usually extra long? But what changed? The things that were once Christmas treasures have become everyday bubbles, most especially the Christmas rice and chicken. Celebrating Christmas doesn't change much. Some of the tradition is always there though. What changes is how we want to celebrate it. Our preferences have changed as we grew older. The way we celebrate it then will be continued or preferred by the future generations or by our children as we start to have our own family. The magic of Christmas for us lies not in its celebration, but rather its impact and family bonding.
Well, there you have it, Christmas then and now. It's still Ibrand TV Christmas special, and of course it's a more interesting time in the studio here, and I'm sure you're having a nice time out there too. Well, Margaret, I mean, my experience about Christmas then, well, when I was much younger or when I was a kid, you know, those days when you Christmas is approaching, what we do is you start expecting your Christmas clothing, you know, gift, shoes, getting them ready, and then the that impression of, okay, you have to dress all up, working group, visit house door to door, get some what's it called now, money, or whoever gives you money, then you come back, you keep it, or you show your parents and all of that. I mean, do we still have all of that today? I'm not sure we have all of that today anymore.
The trend is gradually changing. Okay. It hasn't even changed gradually, because imagine as a child you were allowed to go house to house. How many parents want their kids to do that in these days where insecurity is like the order of the day? Now, that aside, the economy then, I think it was more stable, if you ask me, compared to now, that the price of, I think someone was saying chicken is now about 18,000 naira, there about 12,000 naira, the live chicken, which was not the case back then. Look at oil.
Depends, 7,000, 5,000, and all of that.
Did we even buy chicken of 7,000 then? I think it was 1,200 or one something.
Or maybe 500.
Well, I don't know, maybe your time, in my time it was about
so what do you mean? I'm not too old. I'm just
now we're sharing experiences right now, right? Okay, but then everything skyrocketed, so you can't even, the trend has changed. I remember growing up, as at from the 1st of December or towards the end of November, mom would come around with broom and she would measure your legs, yeah, to get shoes for you, both the length and the width of your leg to get shoes. So she's taking those things, measurements to the market, and she's getting shoes for you. And remember those, that time it used to be, there's this, okay, throwing banga and knockouts was not the thing for us, because if my dad catches, if he, you dare throw banga on the road, you're dead. You don't even do that. Or you dare, now the system we used to have as children, this card, uncle, sign for me now. You sign what you will see.
Oh, yes, I remember. Remember now.
And then, I don't know, my dad just didn't like all of those things. If he sees you, you dare do that, you are, because he felt like we're begging money. But that, it wasn't really about the money they give to us, it was just that fun of sign for me. So, if you want to give me a shoe, you sign shoe. Most times, it's money. And it was, I think it was fun.
But it was fun, really.
It wasn't about the money. It wasn't begging to us. It was just, and people were so glad to do. You see,
there was
cats.
Something about them, really. Yeah. Something about that is the spirit of brotherhood.
Exactly.
Really. The spirit of you watching over my back, all right? Back then, you could decide to leave your children
with your neighbor
and go out there. You could allow your children to go to the next house. Mm. To eat food, but it's no longer like that again. Yeah. Why? Maybe because, like you said earlier, the security issues and all concerns and all of that, and again the fact that you no longer can trust the next person, the next door neighbor, and all of that. So it's that we're having a society that is losing its core value of value for life. You know, value for things that are germane. Not now that we're losing our sense of value. We're losing our sense for human life. We're no longer pro-life. Those days, those things are there. Mm. Sometimes I just wish I could return back to that.
And the most striking thing about those days is the fact that as I'm saying those days, I'm beginning to feel like I am very old.
Not too far away, just about 2-3 decades ago.
So it was the fact that every child was your child. Imagine my parents, or for instance, you have a child and your child does something wrong, you're not around. I'm at liberty to scold the child and even punish the child if need be. And when you come back, you're telling me thank you for even punishing the child.
Mm.
Because imagine the child playing in the rain, you know, you could get cold and you're like, leave the rain, he doesn't do it or she doesn't do it. And then you spank the child or you punish the child.
Right.
So when you as a parent come back, you're grateful. Frank, thank you for helping me watch my child. If he does something next time, flog him again. It's not wicked, but over now, you can't do it anymore. Intruding. Why are you to, not that you hit the child because you want to be wicked, but why are you to touch my child? And now it even gives children the liberty to know that I can do anything. Mommy's not around, that's not around, nobody's going to question me. Those times, you can't even do that. And you could see, I know growing up then, we had some tenants we had a particular tenant who was Muslim. So in their during their festive period, they bring you could see the bowl of rice. You could tell people they're not rich people now, but you would see the bowl of rice and
the spirit of hospitality.
And the fact that my dad was one of the landlords, so even when they are sharing for little quantities for other people, co-tenants, but my dad's own is always big, and we do the same during Christmas, not because we're talking about spooky, but it was because everybody could come together in the compound and you eat together. Can I have something? It was a happy lifestyle. Decorate your houses, people come to play with your children, but now you don't have all those things anymore.
We hope to return to that good old days. If we still have the good old days too.
Memorable part was the Mr. Big's part. We would have to go to every Christmas to eat, you know, some beautiful delicacies we haven't had before.
Yes,
all right, Frank.
I think we need to, for those who are wondering, the essence of Christmas, I think it's time to go back there and just listen to the essence of Christmas. Okay, so let's quickly take a break. When we come back, of course, we have a cleric, a pastor will be joining us via the telephone to share with us what exactly these Yuletide stand for. Please stay with us.
Glad to have you back on Ibrand's special Christmas edition. It's Christmas Day and we're still wishing you a Merry Christmas from all of us on iBrand TV. And now it's time to go straight into the discussion segment where we'll be talking about the essence of Christmas. What really is Christmas? What is Christmas all about? There's some misconceptions and we'll have all of them cleared today because we have with us connecting via audio call Pastor Paul Briggs. Hello, Pastor Paul Briggs. Happy Christmas to you.
Happy Christmas to you too as well. And I'm excited to be on this particular show today. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for joining us.
All right, first of all, it's Christmas Day. Like I said, there are some misconceptions about Christmas. What really is Christmas? People have different things to say about Christmas. But then we're having you right now. We want you to help us shed more light on Christmas itself. What does Christmas really mean?
Like, thank you so much. You know, like the name signifies Christmas, which is Christmas. So, and that is talking about Christ Jesus. So Christmas is about Jesus Christ, and that is really what Christmas is all about. He is the reason for the season, and that is what it is, Christmas. You know, the Bible says in Isaiah 9, it says, "Unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace." I mean, and that's what he came to do, to bring peace between God and man. And this is what Christmas is all about. It's about Jesus. Now, there are a lot of misconceptions, you know, because a lot of times people just feel Christmas is about chopping fried rice and, you know, partying and, you know, those having fun. Well, it's part of celebration, but the real essence of what we're celebrating is the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And that is really the essence. So we must know what we are celebrating, really. Mm-hmm. It's not just celebrating for celebrating sake. We must really know the essence of why we're celebrating, and it's Jesus. He is the reason for this season.
Mm. Okay, help us understand, what are some of the lessons you think we can pick up from the celebration of today across the world that we can actually apply to our life, practical daily living?
Beautiful, and I like that question because, you see, the truth about it is that the Bible also says that God is love. 1 John 4:8, that God is love. And so Jesus is the express image of the Father. That is God. So that makes him love. And so what he came to do on earth is to bring love, you know, humanity between God and man, and share the love of God to man. For God so loved the world, John 3:16, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. So it's about love. So it's about sharing. It's about giving. It's about helping. You know, now it's not just only supposed to be on a particular date and a day, which happens to be 25th of December. It has to be all through our lives. You know, love should be shared. Love is given. Love is touching lives. So it's about people. It's about loving people. It's about sharing what you have with people. And so, practically, how we extend this love that God has given us is by loving people too as well. In many ways, you can love them. Letting them know that they're not alone. In this time, I know the situation in the country now, and things are like the world is. Things are like tough. There's a lot of stuff going on around the economy and all that. So people right now need to feel this love more than ever. They need to feel this love. I mean,
just to add up to that question, we talk about giving every other time, but more importantly is that a lot of clerics emphasize giving much more now in this season than any other time. Why is that?
Well, honestly, I guess it's not the season, you know, because it's not the season, and because of the season, particularly, people tend to emphasize more on giving in this time. But really, we should be giving any other time. We should be doing that more. And that should be the spirit behind the season, you know, our lives to give, because that's what Christ came to do. He gave his life. So we need to also find a way to give. Now, the reason why this is happening now more, the emphasis is now, is because of the time we're in. You know, the end of the year, the end of the year too. So people are just trying to, you know, they want to do more at this time. They want to give, you know, though I like the question came, thinking about it again, you begin to wonder that, okay, why haven't you been giving from January, February, March, April, May? Why give only when it's actually in December? But I guess it's just the mindset of people at this time, you know, because let me share more with people. But you can do that all through the year. You can actually give all through the year and keep giving. Your life should be a life of giving, really.
Pastor Paul, people celebrate Christmas in different ways. People celebrate Christmas by sharing, giving, partying, clubbing, and what have you, right? So, and also there are some misconceptions, like I earlier mentioned, about Christmas. A lot of people argue that the date, 25th of December, was not when Jesus was born. And now some other persons are saying that it's not about the date. It's about the fact that there is a celebration of the birth of Christ. So with the date, some say the 25th is the day for a setting sun. I can't really remember what that was, but is it about the date or about the fact that there is a celebration?
Thank you. In answer to that question, you know, when we look at the Bible, you know, there's a place Paul was talking about, I believe it's in Romans 14, there about 15, and he was talking about the fact that if you pick a day to celebrate, then it shouldn't be a problem. So whatever date you pick for it shouldn't be a problem. Now, there are a lot of theological, you know, angles of that people have, you know, brought up. It's not the date, it's this day is this day is that. But you see, let's not now begin to beat up ourselves with all these theological angles. Let's just know that what is the real essence of this day. That's the critical thing. So if you decide to put it on October, fine. If you decide to fix it on December, it's okay. If you decide to put it any other day, whatever day you decided to celebrate, celebrate it. And so the date, 25th of December, was picked. And of course, with that, we celebrate that day and as a remarkable day, you know, for this particular season, celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. That's really what it's all about. Now, whatever date you fix, celebrate it. The thing is, we tend to get into a whole lot of rubble on dates and all that. But the thing is, we're celebrating the birth of Christ, that's Jesus. Right. And that is the essence. He's the one we're celebrating. That he came into this world, you know, to deliver men and bring peace to men and God. And that's a real deal. You know, that's a real deal.
Okay, let's try to wrap it up with this one now, Pastor Paul. I mean, you talked about the fact that it's a time to celebrate, give back, and you also talk about the fact that it's not just about food alone. But for those who do not have food to even eat at this time, it's for to them, the season, there's no celebration for them. Now, how should those people appreciate this season with one message or Christmas message from you? Let's go.
Okay. Come again. Let me get the message again.
Okay. I was asking you that for those who do not have anything to celebrate with, because you talked about the fact that, yes, it's not just about food, celebration, and all of that. So beyond that, there are some people who do not even have food to eat. They don't have anything to celebrate with. So how should that or those set of people appreciate this season? And I'm saying, give us your Christmas message as we drive home.
Okay, now I would say, like I said initially, it's about Jesus. And it's about the fact that God sent his son to die for man and to bring man back with God. Peace between God and man. So I believe celebrating for those kind of people, celebrating this season can be in a way of you coming to, you know the love of Christ for yourself and celebrating the fact that you are now one with Christ. In a nutshell, coming to the knowledge of this saving grace of Christ Jesus. Because if you don't have that, really, if you don't come to know this Jesus for yourself, not just hearing about him, but coming to know him for yourself, you have to ask yourself, then really, what am I celebrating? Because that is the real deal. Coming into relationship with Christ Jesus. And really, that is really the real deal. Coming into relationship with him, because that is what God wants. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. So God wants us to have everlasting life. And when you come to know Christ, I mean, that is enough to celebrate. You don't have food to eat, then you thank him. You bless him. You adore him. You glorify him. You celebrate him in your life.
I think it's a good time to leave it there.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Pastor Paul Vicks, for sharing.
Thank you for your time. I mean,
it's been amazing.
Margaret, I mean, this, of course, is an eye-opening for
correct,
me
yeah.
And for a lot of people out there, because he said it's not just about food.
Mm.
And he just responded to that question. How about those people who do not have food, who are bothered, worrying, and say, I do not have food. I can't even afford anything. So what he's saying is, look, if they cannot afford food, just know that the season is not just about food alone. You know? So, I mean, it's a good time for us to start reflecting.
Reflecting, that's going to say that. It's also a good time to, while you're celebrating, the fact that you should not say Christ out of the picture, because Christ is the reason for all of this beautiful celebrations we're having.
And more importantly, if you have food to celebrate with, that's also okay.
You should share. It's about sharing and caring. All right, now it's time for us to link up to Bolanle for the business segment. We'll be right back.
The year is running to an end, and we all know what that means. Another festive season is here, time to party, chill with friends, extend your love and appreciation to family and loved ones by buying them gifts. Do you want to make some extra cash this Christmas? Are you searching for the most trending and profitable Christmas business ideas? Well, let's bring you a list of chosen top most profitable Christmas business opportunities for your ready reference. The first business idea we're going to be talking about is sale of gift hampers. This season, people are looking for what to buy for their friends and loved ones, and a nicely packaged hamper is a good gift idea. Now, all you have to do is pen down what you need to make your gift basket attractive. Provisions, canned or packaged foodstuff, kitchen utensils, wines, juice are some of the items you can put inside the hamper. Take lovely pictures of the hampers, post on social media, and put up your number for people to call. You can spice things up by arranging free delivery for buyers that live around you, and voila, you're in business. Okay, business idea two is acting as middleman between buyers and sellers. People are always looking for who will help them deliver goods to their customers. And we all know December, it is a time when people travel to visit their hometown, so sellers are always looking for people to help them deliver their products. Now, this idea is not capital intensive, but it can be stressful, although it is a good way for students to make extra cash during the break. Now, with the money you make, you can support your parents when they tell you they do not have the usual amount they give you to school. Business idea three is cleaning services. Now, most homes this season are looking to clean their homes thoroughly,
And in between going to work, shopping, taking care of the kids, there is no time to do that. You can always volunteer to clean the house for them for a fee. Arrange a team that you know can work with you and be sure to work with your client's time schedule. Business idea 4 is retail of foodstuff and chickens. Now, foods and chickens are almost a necessary part of the Christmas celebration. To make an even bigger profit from selling chickens and foodstuff, it is better to buy directly from a farmer. With a discount on the goods, you will make more than buying from the market. And of course, do not forget to leverage on the social media to advertise your goods. Moving on to business idea 5, which is the final one, the retail of clothes, whether used or unused. Now, because we all want to look good, looking good is good business, right? A good business you can do this period is selling clothes. It doesn't matter if they are secondhand clothes, new ones, or native materials. All you have to do is find your target market. You can spice things up by adding shoes, pieces of jewelry, makeup kits to the equation. If you can make hair, this is the time to make money from that knowledge. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram are good places to advertise your wares. Now, these are some of the 5 things you can do this holiday to make money. Use your social network account to your advantage. Advertise your goods and services there and get your friends to do the same for you too. Don't forget the traditional form of advertising, which is word of mouth. This is also a creative way to let people know you're selling something or offering a particular service. And above all, make sure you make out time for friends and family this Christmas and catch all the fun you can. I am Omobolanle Adesue. Bye for now.
Once we enter Mbom month like this, everybody get happy, so we don't day Mbom month. So I'll take the studio people as they come out, come outside and they say, the outside is good, but here outside they hot as people don't they vex. So everything with a touch hand for market, the price don't go up. And we do for Jodu Bega area for Lagos, we want to talk to different people, people where they sell, people where they buy. May they tell us as they take few. If this Christmas they made their body sweet like jollof rice, and we know see the rice and stew, now they specially cook for December period for Christmas, as today at Christmas, if you enter everybody house now, rice and still they cook. But more ask people if their body they sweet like jollof rice or their body they pepper like pepper soup. But make we find out from them, may they tell us how they feel. If their mind they sweet as things say hi, as all, they just want to do Christmas as it be. So follow me, my name is Kaliebi, and I day for iBrand TV for outside, it hot.
This is tasking, I must tell you, it's very, things are very expensive. Price has gone up terribly high, more than double the previous prices. I don't know what the government can do about it for us, but for goodness sake, we need a respite. This is terrible.
I bow to the matter. I don't know what to say because the situation is really horrible. But I feel so terrible for the less privileged. There are so many people that cannot afford to buy these things. If some people can afford, that's a little bit okay. But how about the downtrodden? How about the middle class? How about the low class? Can they afford to have a decent meal on Christmas Day? I don't know, but something should be done about it. We shouldn't get to a point in this nation where the less privileged would not even be able to have afford a decent meal, let alone look good or be able to afford clothes for their kids to wear on Christmas Day. You know, back then Christmas Day was, it used to be a time of celebration, a time where people give gifts to other people. But can you afford to even have a meal in your house, let alone give any other person a gift? So it has become so horrible in this nation. But I think I believe in God, and I hope someday or somehow we'll get out of the situation.
Everything has increased. And I look at now, people are moving around, no money at the bank, even ATM, no money. Some people go from far to this place to come and look for money in the bank. So this Christmas season is so difficult for people to celebrate because of the high cost of goods. And no, everywhere is just cashless. So the little one we have, we manage it.
this Nigeria where we're there now, things is too high, marketing is cost, we cannot buy anything now for market. People are crying, children are crying. We cannot feed our baby. One pint of garri now is 1,500. Before you go say make you go for Ororo, one plastic of Ororo now is just small bottle, is 1,000. Before we buy granite oil, 300, 250. Now we cannot buy anything for Nigeria. May government help us.
Now, you don't pay me, the two way they buy something, 5,000 before. Now, they buy 12,000, 30,000. Now, if something where watermelon where you got it, 1,2, 1,3, 1,5. If you want sell them, if you tell another person 2,000, you say, why you talk like that? Why you talk like that? I tell, let me know your question. The two are buying, I'll cancel and do that. Now, so, if you say, why, now, one say, no, nobody question. Me are you, now you question.
As I'm not here, where it hurts outside, we call you, we ask people, some people don't understand that government, now they make things they high, as they put money for fuel and other things. People say, no, some people just say, no, not be government, oh, now we, now we do ourselves. But for this Christmas, now to jolly, they share gifts to our family and our friends. But now, how can I go back inside studio, where it cold inside? For me, from Calliope, now bye-bye for this street, now day.
All right, let's talk business now. It's Christmas and a lot of people are doing a lot of buying and selling. People are traveling home to see their family and loved ones. And as we know, it is a season of sharing and giving. And of course, we see the prices of food, goods and commodities on the hike. And this happens every year, especially during the Yuletide. This is what we will be focusing on today on iBrand TV. My name is Omobolanle Adeshui. And joining me to discuss this is Odusheson Okwande. He is a chartered accountant and public affairs analyst. Hello, good morning to you.
Good morning, Bolanle.
And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. First and foremost, let's thank God for life. It's over 365 days when we have this kind of a thing. And here we are today celebrating Christmas. All the glory to God, at least for life.
Glory to God.
Let's not talk of all the challenges in the air, but that
indeed,
we are
indeed, and the challenges are really enormous.
Yeah, it's not something to come by, but because there is life, we keep the word that there is all.
And it is one of the challenges we would be focusing on today. The fact that we keep having price hike, especially in food commodity. You know that this season, a lot of Nigerians want to buy chicken, they want to cook jollof rice, the food for the season. But it looks like every year we always have that hike. What do you think is responsible for this?
Yeah, well, basically, maybe we'll start with a small economics policy, which is just demand and supply. At this point in time, it's Yuletide, is everybody wanting to celebrate Christmas. And you discover that we've worked right from the beginning of the year. And I think it's a time to give yourself a treat. And everybody wants to buy, whether you need it, you don't need it. This is the time. Your children has done wonderfully well. You want to impress them. You've not been able to attend to one way or the other. You want to. So with that, you discover that you have so much demand. And if you go by simple economics, those days where we're in secondary school, it's just to tell you that when your demand outweighs your supply, definitely there will be increase in price.
Mm.
What is our supply level as we speak? You and I know that it's very, 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 very low. And I have to use that very in so many times because of the level of insecurity. Our farmers are not out there in the farm to plant things. You know, come again with COVID. The challenge we faced, the pandemic period, several people were held back home, not able to go to farm. The fundamental is, if there is insecurity and people are unable to go to farm, how do we get the food? So the supply definitely will be having a shortfall.
So indeed the major issue is the insecurity issue, especially for farmers.
It plays a major role because when you are not out there to produce, just like we are having here today, if the production crew are not here, are we going to have any output? The answer is zero. So but there will be demand. People will be expecting. Mm. Ah, what are they going to show today? What would they be there? So the farmland for us, even here, is the production crew be making themselves available? Situation where they are not, definitely there is nothing. But there will be demand, expectation that people are going to buy those commodities. So first and foremost, demand and supply, which the limit for the demand, for the supply, is as a result of farmers not going to the farm, and that is as a function of insecurity.
And we must also look at the fact of the purchasing power of the average Nigerian, which has drastically dropped. Income has not increased, but the prices keep going up.
Yeah, there is no how income will increase. You know, insecurity, COVID-19 or the pandemic period that ravaged the world, actually sent so many people out of the out of work. So many organizations could not stand the challenges of COVID, and they ran into making half payment.
And there were layoffs.
You know, some were layoff, some were even begging, "Don't worry, I will come to work without doing anything, all in the name of I just want to keep myself busy." So because of this, indeed, the purchasing power of an average Nigerian, as we speak, has actually dropped down. And I was on the particular program, and we're just cracking jokes. And I don't know if you noticed it, that Santa Claus is not actually in town. Somebody said he has Omicron and he has decided to go into hiding. But you remember while we were growing up, this is a season we all expect. You go to stations like this where people celebrate, go to the mall. But averagely, if you go anywhere, it's a low key that everybody is trying to play. And when you look at
the mood is not really high.
While I was coming here, I'm sure you expect that it will be a jamboree here and there. Those days you have carnival. That is in the midst of plenty. But as we speak, everybody is just trying to keep their feet. And let me also remind you, this is a season that some of my friends, let me put it, the Easterners, travel home, you know. Most of them don't, they hardly travel during the year. They work all year to make sure that this period, you see that they are out there to celebrate with the family, to get married, to do so many things. And I saw so many of them around yesterday as they even, and I'm like, oh boy, I thought you should be in the village now. Drinking palm wine. I said, how will I go? There is no money. There is insecurity. If they see you out there, they feel you're from Lagos. You can be kidnapped. There is no guarantee of you coming back home. So when you put all this together, it's a problem that we have been asking ourselves. How do you expect an average businessman to survive even in the years ahead?
And there's also the report from the World Bank saying that the poor Nigerians have actually increased. The number of poor Nigerians have increased over the past few months.
Of course, of course. I said it while I was saying it the other time that most people lost their job, and most businesses are not out there. I can use myself as a practical example. I'm into a business that I travel a lot within the states. I'm in the west, today I'm in Akure, tomorrow I'm in Enugu, in the north, everywhere, because of the nature of my business. But since the insecurity started, COVID, in the last 2 years, I've not actually traveled, except for Abuja, that you can easily just fly to. But every other area, those days I hardly fly. I can connect myself from Akure to the east, from the east, connect to the north. I can drive all the way from here to Lagos. I have a driver.
But right
drive
now,
myself.
If you can't fly,
you
just can't
do
sit back
some
home.
Of those things. So you just stay back. And what does this pose to businesses? Most of the people, when you are not there to keep an eye on them, most of my staff would tell you that Oga can bounce on us unannounced. I'm a trained chartered accountant who, most of the time when we want to carry out our stock intakes, we don't announce to the people that will come in, because you need to check those things. But as we speak, everybody will just tell you, we saw Oga on here. Oga cannot travel. With the level of insecurity, cannot risk it. So those are the challenges that we are faced with. And you see, intra and interstate businesses enhance the quality, because we depend on one another. If you look at the food itself, it is not grown only in the southwest here. You bring it from the north. How safe are the people? You have heard several news. It's in the public domain. There was an adoption on Kaduna Abuja Road. We have it in Zamfara. We have even commissioners, honorable of some states in the northwest, being killed.
Isn't it strange that we keep seeing the inflation rate drop, especially between March and November or October thereabout? We saw the inflation rate drop drastically, and it looks like it's not reflecting in the price prices of commodities?
Yeah, there are so many things that is entrenched into inflation. If you look at the statistics, we have food inflation and we have the inflation instead. Food inflation is not dropping. It keeps going up. That MBS has actually been putting out, I think as at the last report, it was about whether 18 or 20%. So, but for the normal inflation, there are so many things that are entangled with that. It's not just about the food alone. You and I will know that there are still businesses that are still moving. You talk about the telecoms, the IT people, they are still making waves. And that's have its own contributing factor, even to the bottom line, as a nation. Mm. So with that, when you look at other areas, as some are complaining, the other aspect are actually saying, okay, there is a boom. You've seen situation with the introduction of 5G, people going to raise funds and pay so much, to acquire that. You ask yourself, where do you... So some sectors are actually feeling it, as the other sector are actually. If you go to the hoteliers now, they will complain to you that business has not been as usual, tourism has not been, been promoted as it used to be. Mm-hmm. This is the season that we all save. I'm sure nobody will want to pick me down for an interview. It's either I'm out of the country with my family or not, but where do you want to go? You go to UK, they tell you to pay so much for a test and all those things. So everybody had to retire back home. And you discover there are those other businesses that are suffering. Some are actually enjoying it. Look at people have to work from home. The cost of data has to go. So those ones are making it.
But
so when you put those things together,
you
discover that inflation rate in global can be dropping, but the food inflation keep increasing because our demand at Twitter.
So in wrapping up, how do we balance things up for Nigerians? How does the common man out there not really feel the impact of this?
Well, Bolanle, except we are deceiving ourselves, we will continue to feel the impact in the sense that until we have the security apparatus checked in. At this point, I want to sincerely appreciate the men in uniform. They are really trying. They are really putting in their best. Even though their best is not good enough, I read a report where it was made known that we have over 900 of this personnel being killed. They have families, they have loved ones, and they are nowhere to be, now missing those people out in the land. So until we address the issue of security, where people, an average Westerner travels to the north to bring foodstuff without anybody bringing it for her. You go there, you negotiate. But now they cannot even go to the farm. Who do you transact business with? So the first cardinal thing that must be addressed, like I read this morning of our president telling us that we are the final laps of putting an end even to this terrorism and banditry. Well, we watch out for it, because I asked in the program I had this morning, I've never known of the stages of phases that we've passed through, that the president is telling us we are the final stage. But that's a topic for another day.
All right.
Let this be addressed, that people can leave the comfort of their home, transact business interstate. Our road infrastructure must be...
We won't actually talk more on that, because we have to take a break now. We'll be back to talk about the hike in transportation fares, especially during Yuletide in Nigeria. Please stay with us.
Christmas, like every other festival, comes with its attendant peculiarity, especially with the movement of commuters from one place, state, or country to another, and has huge financial implications. Here in Lagos State, there's usually heavy traffic of commuters to other parts of the country during the Yuletide. This heavy traffic of commuters during the festive season forces up transportation fares and compel many commuters to seek even riskier alternatives than the regular motor parks. A visit to some parks in Lagos State revealed that transport fares have been increased by as much as 50%, in some cases, thereby putting pressure in the pockets of many Nigerians.
But 5,000, 4,000, 5,000, now it's 9,000 to worry. That is out of the range. It's greed. I must let you know. It's greed. Generally in Nigeria, we blame government.
but the corruption is from grassroots. What has changed? Was the fuel price increased? Or the road nomenclature has changed? Nothing has changed. The only thing that has changed is the greed. Capability of men and women to cheat others.
Transportation was 8,000, but presently we are paying 11,000. So the difference is big.
Explaining the motive behind the increase in transport fare this season, these commercial bus operators said they have no option than to raise the fares as there are only few passengers coming from other parts of the country to Lagos State.
At this period, we are collecting 12,000, and that's because there are no passengers in the east. So each driver are giving them money to and fro to go and come back. So it's 12,000. Uber, 14,000. Port Harcourt is 15,000.
Moto wa repete nlele moto ri bi lo be ba gugu bi ko se ro ko se ro gba mi ale wa lataro osule ko je ke moto meji lo ma load
maybe 2,000 3,000 yeah 2,000 3,000 increase.
One question that comes to mind is, why do people want to travel last minute during festive periods?
This time you have free time to travel. You cannot leave your work and start traveling, but this period now people are free to travel. Understand, and it's, you know, definitely was travel to go and celebrate to people, so it's a festive period, so that's why we are waiting until this time to travel.
To reduce possible road crashes this Yuletide, most commuters are calling on the officers of the Federal Road Safety Corps to up their game by putting motorists using the highways on check. I, Buji Horia, reporting for Ibrand TV News.
Welcome back. We're still talking Christmas, talking about the hike in the cost of transportation, the cost of food. But right now, we're going to be focusing more on the cost of transportation. I still have with me Okwade Odusheson, Chartered Accountant and Public Affairs Analyst. Thank you so much for staying with us.
My pleasure with you.
Now, let's focus on the cost of transportation. Now, the National Bureau of Statistics, that's the NBS, says the average airfare rose by 0.25%. That's from October 2021 to November 2021. That's just within the space of 1 month. How do you react to this?
Yeah, I got the report last week about the increase in the airfare. You know, we have different diverse means of transportation, but as we speak, if we must talk of interstate, it is via the air flights that people travel these days because of the security level. And it still go back to the fundamental. I said, well, I was discussing the issue of food. It's about demand and it's about supply. The cost of things on the part of the aviation sector is nothing to come by, considering the fact that majority of the things that they use in that sector are import-based. We don't have any that we produce locally here, even for them
even
to
the
service.
Airplanes.
The airplane to service it. It's not even to buy it now. To service, we don't have local content that service that as you service your car and mine. So they have to take it out there. I have had calls to relate with one or two of these air companies, and you discover that the cost of foreign exchange has actually hyped the cost of their operation too. And that impact on it. And that's why they feel that, okay, this is the yuletide period that an average person wants to travel. And considering the fact that nobody wants to travel by road because of the insecurity, they have to fall back on them. And that has actually increased the demand. And they feel that this is an opportunity for us to just tap into it. And that has gone seriously up. If you look at the cost of transportation to by road, same is applicable. Everybody.
Well, sorry to butt in. Even before the insecurity issue became so aggravated, the cost of transportation has always gone up every Yuletide season.
Yeah, it still boils down to the level at which I would say demand and supply. Everybody at this period, you ask yourself, during the Yuletide period, we have so much traffic. Think about the yesterday, 24th. Everywhere was jam-packed. everybody is looking for a way to buy things, to get things up. And if you have about 5 cars, daddy will take out car, mommy will take out car, the housewife will take on, the children will go out to the mall or have fun and do so many other things. So,
but can you blame them? The government hasn't provided sustainable means. For instance, if the train network was working, everyone wouldn't have to go with their cars.
Yeah, well, the federal government has actually told us that they're actually working on the infrastructure. We've seen some of the rail being put into construction with the promise of some of this thing coming to bear in the year 2022. We all await this. Until we have an integrated transportation mode, that is, you can go out. Like I remember those days, several people worked on the island, stay at Ikorodu. They go via the ferry within 30, 45 minutes. But you ask yourself, how safe are some of those things, even on the waterway? That's why we have asked. Put measures of safety for people to go through there. You can go via rail. If you travel out of this country, you see minimally, people go around by cars. You join the train. And not the
even
train
in developed countries.
You go by train. Within an hour, you can move from here to Ilorin, and you are out there. Government is trying their best. Like I know about the train system between Lagos and Ibadan. It's been operational, and I've heard of
how effective is it?
Yeah, it does. It does. I have friends that come all the way from Ibadan. As a matter of fact,
you know, the promise was that when this is operational, then people would be able to work in Lagos and live in Ibadan.
Yeah, that's it's operational now. I know of a friend who has actually relocated to Ibadan fully because of the cost of things in Lagos. While he was here, he paid so much million for his apartment. And he was able to get something bigger than that, less than 500,000 in Ibadan. So his family are out there. He comes to Lagos. At least he comes via a train, 8 in the morning, by 9:30 he's in Lagos. And there's another one that leaves Lagos around 4 in the evening to Ibadan. So he shuttles that on daily basis, and he's not been complaining. I've heard of announcement of them saying rather than the 2 segments that they're going to run, that they've been running for this year period, they are running about 3-4. So we see some of those things coming up. Those in the worry also are saying that those are operational. Right. So I believe that let's give government more time. As they are, we've seen the physical structure.
You seem to have a lot of faith in the government, and I think I like that.
Because I have no other place to go. This is my country.
Uh-huh.
And when you keep faith and hope in them, I think something positive is tends to come.
All right, I like the positivity, and that's what we need this Christmas. A very big thank you to you, Odusheson Okwade, Chartered Accountant and Public Affairs Analyst. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
And have a fantastic Christmas.
Just that after now, I think I will take some chicken. So I'm stepping out of the studio to enjoy
Not a problem.
To enjoy my...
All right. All right, this is where we're leaving. My name is Omobolanle Adeshi. Bye for now.
Richard Godrich once said that Christmas is like candy. It slowly melts in your mouth, sweetening every taste bud, making you wish it could last forever. But you can make it worth remembering when you do things you've never did before or go places you've never been before this season. With Christmas in the air, every fun-loving person will be thinking of an amazing place to be with their loved ones, aside from embarking on the usual traditional trip to the village for extended family reunions. They are unique and classic places where fun lovers can go across the 6 geopolitical zones in Nigeria to spend the Christmas vacation. Places to visit like the Tenapa Resort. Tenapa Resort is a business and leisure resort located in Calabar, the beautiful capital of Cross River State in the south. The resort offers an amazing features like casino, children's arcade, retail and wholesale outlet for your shopping needs, and an 8-screen digital cinema. Another place where you can visit is the Yankari Game Reserve. This large wildlife park, located in Bauchi State, came into being in 1956 as a game reserve but was later turned into a national park in 1991. The park covers an area of about 2,244 square kilometers, and it's home to about 50 species of wildlife such as lion, leopard, hippopotamus, antelope, elephant and water buck, as well as over 350 species of colorful birds. The reserve equally boosts decent and affordable accommodation for visitors. If you visit the Yankari Game Reserve this Xmas, don't forget to take a dip in the warm spring. But remember always to guard your belongings against the baboons. Also, you can visit the Oguta Lake Resort, also known as the Lake of Treasure. It is located in Oguta, a quiet town about 30 minutes drive from the ever busy capital of Imo State, Owerri. The most striking part of this park is the confluence of the Oguta Lake, which is blue, and the muddy Ula Sea River, with both maintaining their unique colors. Even an attempt to miss the two by scooping water from one to another will only leave a stain for a short while. This is better seen than reading or imagined. Moving to the southwest town part of Nigeria, you can visit the Ikogosi Warm Spring and Resort, and this is yet another mind-blowing tourist center to spend the Christmas holiday without spending a whopping amount of money. You can unwind the past month with your family at this natural spring resort. The tourist attraction is a place where a natural warm spring meets and flows side by side with cold spring at a confluence, each maintaining its terminal properties. It is surrounded by natural beauty, such as hills and lush grounds. It is a home away from home. Ikogosi is located at Ekiti State on a well-landscaped of 116 hectares. Ikogosi Warm Spring and Resort is a leading tourist destination in the country. The resort facilities are built in conformity with international standards, and they offer first-class customer satisfaction with an equi-site restaurant serving intercontinental dishes as well as local flavor. So why don't you take a hike and unravel the mystery behind the cold and warm springs of Ikogosi this Christmas season? Now moving to Olomorok, this amazing granite rock used to be a place of refuge for the people of Egbaland and the present Ogun State during the intertribal wars in the olden days. It has several sport caves, some of which are about 20 feet long and 25 feet wide. However, this rock has been modernized with elevators, eateries, and many more to serve as a tourist destination. One can as well choose to take the staircase instead of the elevator to the top of the rock. This scenery at the top of the rock is better experienced than told. These are some of many places you can visit this Christmas. Have a wonderful and prosperous Christmas.
This is still iBrand TV Christmas Special Edition. I hope you're having a Merry Christmas, a frolicking time, and I'm sure you are enjoying the show because I am enjoying the show. Franco also,
we are enjoying the show. I mean, it's amazing. It's amazing in here.
Yeah, I like the spirit of Christmas. I like the smell of Christmas, the feel of Christmas. I feel so good today. All right, it's Christmas Day, like I said, and that places you can visit. You don't have to stay in the house and lie down and be boring at home. Please get up from that bed and visit some beautiful places we're just about to mention right now. So Frank, do you have some places in mind for us?
Oh yes, my favorite place, or will I say one of my favorite really, is the Lekki Conservation, where you have the high sky walkway up there, about 1,000 feet above the ground, where you're up there, you'll be so scared as if, I mean, you're going to go down in a moment, but it's a place to be. If you can conquer that fear from up there, really, I mean, psychologists say you can actually conquer anything.
Oh, really? While you were talking, something really, really silly came to my head. Silly and funny. I was just thinking, now, I'm sure that thing has a stronghold, right?
I've not like been there. Kind of phobia.
No, not of course. People who have phobia for height may not be able to do that. But I'm like, right, that stuff holding the long canopy work has a strong, very strong stuff holding it. So my mind was just going, what if an average Nigerian would say, what if your village people are monitoring you through their mirror and that thing decides to cut when you are there? Okay, now that's me being funny, right?
I mean, when you're catching fun, you're not really thinking about that, really. For some people, I've seen people who have walked that walkway many times, who are thinking through many things, and they tell you, I've conquered my fears.
Oh, I think I should do that. Okay, for me,
it's a nice place to be.
All right, I am a lover of nature, and I like somehow I just like the feel of natural air. I like, interestingly, I like to see the waters,
like waterfalls.
It's therapeutical for me. Right. I like to look at, like when I go to the beach, I really do not go for any other thing than to just sit somewhere secluded. I have my headphones, probably a bottle of wine by me, alone, and I'm looking at the water. That fun of the waves. People have said so many things. Margaret, you know, you're light skinned, you shouldn't be that, like, but that's you being superstitious. Overly superstitious. Now, I like, because I'm a lover of nature, I'd rather go to the beach, have that feel of nature around me, or a waterfall, or somewhere natural, a garden or something, not really somewhere you. And also, there's this thing somewhere in Victoria Island, Lagos State, it's called a silent disco headsets. You have your own music, someone listens to his or her own music, and people are dancing, but they're listening to different music, and there's no noise, it's just you on your own. I think that's one of the places I would like to visit.
Let me just say, of course, we're laying a disclaimer, we're not suggesting anywhere you should go.
It's personal,
of course, this is personal.
Yeah,
I mean, anyone can choose anywhere you want to have fun.
Correct.
Or visit this your time. Today is Christmas Day. I mean, it's holiday, it's a long holiday, so you can just choose.
You can choose, and I'm talking about places I would love. And if I were to be in Port Harcourt now, I would have visited the Pleasure Park. Like I said, I love parks, I love walking the parks, it's beautiful for me. And in Abuja, there are a couple of parks also in area two. That's not the Kilishi stand. I think the Kilishi market, I think it was it's area one, right? Or area two. I can't remember which of the areas.
There's so many in Abuja. There are so many points or spots for Kilishi, and you see them all around. It's a nice place to behold.
Nice place to be. So it's Christmas Day, do not forget to have fun. And while you're having the fun, please have fun responsibly. You do not want to have any casualty while you're having fun. And if you're in Port Harcourt, please try to have the Port Harcourt Bully. That is an amazing delicacy you don't want to miss. All right, now it's time to delve right into entertainment, but we'll be doing that after the short break. Stay with us.
The Christmas season is one of the most significant and favorite holidays in the world. People associate it with coziness, a decorated Christmas tree, festive lights. But what is Christmas without that steamy, protein-packed jollof rice and properly seasoned grilled chicken with a glass of cold-pressed pineapple or orange juice? A get-together party, everyone with their plates full of food, ready to eat at the dining room table or wherever the celebrations meet them. Sometimes you might have to add tables so everyone and the food can fit. Christmas is here again. All the decorations and lights are up around houses and streets. Christmas trees are beautifully lit like a clear night sky, with a star brightly shining at the top. And what better way to celebrate this festive occasion than with some good food? In Nigeria, Christmas is usually celebrated in style with lots of tasty home-cooked meals. Family and friends from far and wide laughing out loud, reminiscing old memories, catching up on the latest gist, and of course, the big mamas exchanging contact info for wifey husband material. And of course, kids chewing on yummy goodies and either watching a Christmas movie or running around while their moms chase after them with a don't embarrass me look on their faces. In between all of this, the most important thing to anyone and everyone is to enjoy the foods and drinks that come with the season. So if you're looking to fill your table with favorites this holiday season, allow me to share my highly opinionated, completely unscientific Christmas food list. Here are some nice Christmas delicacies you should try. Jollof stuffed chicken. This is a better way to serve jollof rice this year. Let's go tropical with tropical fried rice, a meal that screams festivity. Roasted whole chicken. Number one meal for the day, egusi soup with loads of assorted protein served with a fufu meal. green vegetable garnish, a tasty side meal that would pimp up your dishes from 0 to 100 in no time. Try the yummy mede mede of chicken suya with all the vegetables that go well with suya in one plate. I'm sure a lot of you can relate to the aforementioned meals and will be trying out one or two during this Christmas season. I wish you the yummiest Christmas season, and do remember to eat clean, healthy, and also do not overfeed. Once again, Merry Christmas!
It's still our Christmas edition right here on iBrand TV, a Christmas special. And we have a lot of interesting and exciting packages for you this beautiful Christmas day. And joining us right here in the studio is Michelle Abanu. Michelle, good morning. And this is a beautiful outfit you have. Merry Christmas,
Thank
Michelle.
Thank you. And you look really good yourself. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, Michelle.
Thank you.
And you look gorgeous.
Thank you. I mean, you guys should have told me to come prepared.
You're over prepared.
Exactly,
already.
Of course. You're already looking good. I'm sure you have entertainment news for us.
Of course.
Maybe about fashion or something.
Fashion is Christmas. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, it's all right.
Okay, now let's talk about the first Nigerian Christmas movie, in Nigeria Christmas, directed by Kunle Afolayan. It was launched in Netflix on the 16th of December, and since then, it has been making waves on Netflix. It features a host of all your Nollywood favorite actors, including Mercy Johnson, Kunle Remi, Efa Iwara, Adelaoye, Abayomi Alvin, and the late Rachel Oniga, who plays the loving but relentless mother. Speaking on what this film and song means to the director, Kunle Afolayan says, and I quote, "Culture is everything to me. A Nigerian Christmas soundtrack is not only the first Christmas song of its kind, but it simply transcends Christmas songs to a whole different level, giving it an extra feel of cultural essence, which is what we are all about. It was also an emotional moment for most fans of late star actress Rachel Oniga as they saw her glow in for the last time. It is currently number one on Netflix in Nigeria. So here are some movies you should actually see in this season in no particular order. Of course, in Niger Christmas, The Princess Switch, How to Ruin Christmas, A Christmas Flow, Holidays, Jingle Jangle, A Christmas Journey, and A California Christmas. It's also so evident that a lot of people really just want to relax this season. So here are some places to visit. If you're going out with your kids, you should visit Omo Resort, the aquatic water parks in Lagos, Agodi Gardens and Leisure Park in Ibadan, Playhouse in Edo State, Park Vega Water Park in Delta State, Green Square Amusement Park in Abuja. And then if you're really in that relaxation mode, you should try out beaches and resorts, even though there are tendencies of overcrowding. Then if you're just like me, the no cooking gang, but you really love tasty meals, I guess you should be spending your days in restaurants. And that's all on the news.
Interesting.
Yeah, really interesting. He's
spending your day in the restaurant. How, you know, Christmas Day and Christmas Boxing Day, New Year Day, and then the next day after, the day after, are crowded. Like, it's so crowded. Cinemas are crowded. The beaches are crowded. Every single place is crowded. So in those days, I just really like to be at home. Maybe wait till all the puzzles and everyone is now tired and just want to rest. That's when I like to go out. So I don't know. This going out on Christmas Day, I don't know if it's a thing for you.
Margaret, trust me, Nigerians like to catch fun. They just love fun.
What crowd?
You will see a lot of them on the beaches, resort, restaurant, amusement park. Just expect them. Exactly. I mean, if you go out tomorrow, in places, I don't want to mention, in some popular restaurant, you will see them there. Almost overpopulated.
I mean, the reason why they are overpopulated is because people love to go out during this season.
Oh, yes.
And you should also know there are levels to these things. Some people just want to go to some really private resorts and they just book and they are just alone, relaxing in their own environment. So there's so many places like that you can actually try out this Christmas.
Now, about the movies you mentioned, you mentioned How to Ruin a Christmas. Even if you didn't mention that, I was going to come to that, because last year, on Christmas Day, it did like this last year. I saw the movie. I saw how the lady in question almost ruined her sister's marriage. And now when I saw the fact that another was going to come out, I couldn't wait for that. I think this particular one, I think there was a funeral or something. I've not seen it. I know it's on Netflix, but I'm yet to see it. There was a funeral. I think she ruined it too. So more like she's the master of the ruin game.
Margaret, I've not seen that.
You've not seen the movie.
if you hire me to review the movie, I will caption it, How Not to Ruin Christmas. But then again, I think it's a good title. Why? Because once you watch the movie, you should be able to avoid not to ruin anybody's Christmas, or I should be able to avoid someone ruining my happiness or Christmas.
Some things
are not planned, really. But one thing, interesting thing about Nigerian movies is that now you have a lot of them on Netflix going crazy. I mean, there are other international organizations who are just, you know, trying to lay holes on our content and all of that, making millions of that. And when you talk about Afolanyo, he's a great producer, from figurine to
Citation.
Really nice those movies have made billions.
Interestingly, if I'm about to see a movie, and if I just see the fact that it's from Kuni Afolayi, I just know that somehow it's going to be an amazing movie. Even when it doesn't seem like it's going nowhere, I just know that at the end I'm going to have an amazing time. Now, talking about the Niger Christmas, Misha, what was your favorite character on that movie? I have a reason why I asked the question.
Okay, for
first,
me...
First, you've seen the movie, right?
Yeah, I have. Okay, first, I would say everybody was, I mean, they really did their best. They did amazing job. But
you have a favorite.
Of course I do. Mm-hmm. Efa Iwara really stood out for me because that was a really tricky character. Mm. Efa, that is not his personality, but for him to keep up with that.
I kept blinking his eye. That's the part that annoyed me the most. Why would he blink it?
It takes a really talented person to actually keep up that act. And so he really stood out for me.
Mm. I think my favorite character was, or is, the lady, the church girl. Now, you know why I said she's a church, not because she's a church girl, but because the captivating moment of when the beginning of the movie, there's this beautiful lady with an amazing voice trying to sing. It reminded me of there's this movie that's I can't remember the name of this movie, where they had Cookie Lion, she had four boys. I'll remember later. So that's a movie that I'll tell you how I love you tonight.
You have such an amazing voice.
No. Because I know that I've... So that movie, it reminded me of that movie, and it was amazing for me. I think the lady, the church lady, she played well at some point, and she took me off my feet at some other point too. So I think that's my favorite character.
I've not seen that movie.
Margaret is really spoiling it for you.
But it's okay. I've seen the trailer, really. But okay. I should go see it and see how it feels. I mean, this is Christmas and time to relax. You mentioned some fireplaces and some other places to review. I think I should take our time, to visit some of those places. Okay, ladies, it's all right. It's an open check for
after
you guys.
After the show today, it's Christmas Day, right?
We are yes.
The bills
open
on
check
you.
For you guys.
All right, thank
bills
you.
Bills on me. Mm. No, no problem.
Also, this is a proof. You can't go back on your word.
Bills on me, bills on me. Anyway, we want to thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.
That's entertainment update. Thank you so much.
Merry Christmas one more time.
See you.
All right, Michelle, that's Michelle right here with us in the studio. We still have another interesting segment for you. Please don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Glad to have you back. Now, this is iBrand TV Christmas special program here. Of course, it's time for sport segment of the program, sport business. Samson Oloyede, sport anchor analyst, is here. Good to see you, Samson.
Thanks for having me.
Merry Christmas, Samson.
Merry Christmas.
And Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you very much.
Now, yes, we're going to talk about the expectation for AFCON. in January.
Definitely.
We'll talk about that. But quickly, let's head back to the street and get to hear what Nigerians are saying. So let's take this insert from the street, what Nigerians or fans are saying about sport.
Osinay Gbagbo is a good coach. Yeah, yeah, let him take them to the Nations Cup. And thereafter, they cannot come together and know who next that will take over the job. I'm of the opinion that we should use indigenous coach. If he take them to the Nations Cup and do well, probably they can still give to him. Or there are so many of them that can only say he's a good coach, but then last time he was there and eventually he left and all that. But then we have so many of them here that can take the job because they know these players. They know they can go to villages and, you know, picture these players out. Not like a foreign coach, he will just come and be looking at people playing in Europe. But there are so many indigenous players that does well, that can, you know, deliver. But some of these foreign coaches will not know them, except they see them playing out there. But the indigenous coaches can go to our local league, picture the best out of them, and then bring them to the Super Eagles, and they will do well.
We have some former international teams that play for Nigeria. They can as well come in, like JJ Okocha, can as well come in and to take the position of general. The
kind of players we have on ground, if we have a good coach, they can do very, very well. But the present coach now, Osinay Gbagbo, can do better. But preferably, I would have wanted to bring a foreign technical advisor that the players will obey and listen to the tactics of how they are going to play. Like the former coach, Garnet Roy, doesn't have tactics at all. We just test running players. That's why we are not performing so good. They should give a Gbagbo trial, and if he couldn't do well, I have to bring a foreign technical advisor.
I think Amnike should, because what Ganero actually started, I actually analyzed it with some of my friends. He actually wanted the work to go on a smooth pace, never bothered himself with home base and the rest. But Amunike should be the best person for the job. Eguavon, we've seen Eguavon's work before, so it is not his first time. Understand? So I think if I'm to pick, I will go for Amunike. And Amunike for me would be the best for the job.
According to the analysis, I don't think that it can lead us to win the Nations Cup. Because even when Genero is still there, at least, although not, he's getting with the result, but the work rate is not there. But he's managing to get out the result. But when they're now bringing the graph, I just come in. He don't even know the players than the person that is there before. Now he's just trying to be, what he's trying to be doing now is try and error. Maybe he can at least grind out some results. But to my own experience, I don't think that he can give us the Nations Cup.
All right, let's get straight into the discussion right away. Samson, yes, I was going to ask you. I know you're smiling now.
Yeah.
And I know why you're smiling, but we'll get to that in a jiffy. What should we be expecting for AFCON 2022? Mm. Of course, it's in January. And
yeah,
few
January
weeks
9th.
To come. Yeah,
January
few weeks
9th.
To come now. So Roy is no longer there.
Definitely.
Igbo has taken over.
Temporarily.
So what's going to happen?
Well, that's where it's dicey, it must be said. We expected Eguavoen to lead, you know, the Super Eagles going into the African Cup of Nations, but that has been cast in doubt because just, you know, barely 2 days ago, the NFF president, Amaju Pinnick, confirmed that they're in talks with several foreign coaches. He even highlighted Jose Mourinho as one of them. And then you also have, you know, the former assistant manager for Portugal also in the mix, talking about Peseiro. So, and what he said that casts doubt regards Eguavoen's, you know, intention or participation at the AFCON is that the new coach would hit the ground running immediately. So there's every possibility that the new coach will be the one to lead the, you know, Super Eagles into AFCON.
So what's Iguavo going to do before then? Well, more like preparing the ground.
Yeah, you know, preparation, you know, training camp and all, because African Cup of Nations 2022 is slated to start on the 9th of January, which is barely 2 weeks away. And the PINIC, you know, the president of the Nigerian Football Federation, confirmed that by next week, we should have a permanent manager in place, talking about the replacement or successor for General. So it's really dicey right now where we stand regards who takes us to African Cup of Nations. And as you heard from the streets, not every Nigerian is particularly convinced that Iguavoen can get the job done in terms of leading the Eagles to glory.
Right now, if the Nigerian Football Federation is trying to hire Mourinho, do you think we can afford him?
Well, definitely we can't. We can't, because when you look at Mourinho's, you know, credentials and his wage bill, or, you know, his annual pay, it's oftentimes in the region of £15 million, sometimes £20 million from the various European clubs.
Annually. All right.
You know, from the various European clubs he has coached over the years, from Chelsea to Tottenham Hotspur, Manchester United, now Roma, you know, amongst others. So when you look at that £15 million, even if it's £10 million a year, you bring it down to what we paid General as at $50,000, you know, a month at some point.
White gap.
By the time you do the mathematics, $50,000 a month is just $600,000 a year. So $600,000 a year to £10 million, it's the gulf is just too wide. So in terms of paying Jose Mourinho's remuneration, yes, we will not be able to do that. But it also shows you the intent that the NFF have for the Super Eagles. The fact that they can go for such a world-class coach who has won it all, you know, everywhere he's been, it just shows you that they are ready to really get a manager who can instill discipline and get the job done for the Eagles, not just on the domestic scene, that's the continental aspect, but also at the World Cup. The World Cup is in a year's time. We need to go there and not just make the numbers.
If at this time we're still talking about, or we have not even arrived at a conclusion, who should take over now, and we're not even sure if Iguavo is the right person to lead the team to AFCON.
And is just so, 2 weeks.
I mean, and it's just a few weeks away. What are we actually getting ourselves into?
That's the concern. But if you go back again and check precedents, you realize that we've been in these situations over time, you know, wherein we'll sack a coach and then just a week or two to another tournament, someone else takes over. Amadou Tribal qualified us to the 2002 World Cup, but he didn't take us to the World Cup. It was Onigbide who took us, you know, to the World Cup. I can mention several, you know, instances where that has happened. Now, is that the right template? You want to question such, you know, implementation of such decisions, but What?
Because I was even going to ask, is it even right in the first place to even let, is it at the right time?
At the right time.
I mean, to let this guy
that's,
go.
That's why people question the timing of General sack.
All right.
Very few people question the sack itself. What people questioned was the timing. Because the African Cup of Nations was less than 2 months, you know. You also had them World Cup qualifiers, and it's the final round, although that will take place in March. You know, a two-legged affair. So there were questions regards, was it the right time to sack General or not? But again, sometimes you make decisions. Life, they say, is a risk, and you just have to make those bold decisions. It pays off sometimes. It doesn't pay off. Let's see if this pays off. But the African Cup of Nations is here, and our last train at the competition was a bronze medal, third place finish. We should, you know, do better this time around.
Well, okay, right now, just before we let you go, really, in terms of budgeting, of course, every sports event and all of that, we budget for it and all of that. But do we have the capacity now? Because at a point, even the NFF was crying foul of a lack of
funds
and all of that. Are we even ready? Do we have the funds?
We've always had those, you know, should I call them concerns or issues, wherein funding is a problem. Remember, before General sacking, it was owed for 8 months. You know, at some point when his contract was renewed from the $50,000, it became $20 million per month, and it was owed for 8 months. Then the NFF had to pay for 5 months first, there was still a 3 months outstanding, you know, balance and all of that. We've always had those things. But when it comes to competitions,
right,
like African Cup of Nations, the World Cup, even if it's at the last minute, there will be funding.
I think we should leave it there. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for having me.
For that, you know, spot update.
Timely spot update. Thank you very much.
Mm.
All right. Thank you, Samson, for that sports update. You're still watching Ibrand TV Christmas special. So we'll take a break now. We will come back. Of course, it will be time for shout out with one of our own who is celebrating her birthday today. Please stay with us.
Glad to have you back. It's still Ibrand TV, and yes, it's our Christmas edition on Ibrand TV. Interestingly, today is Christmas Day, and not only is it Christmas Day, it's also the birthday celebration of one of our amazing presenters and colleagues right here in Ibrand TV. Don't worry, you'll meet her very soon. It's an important day for us, and she's dragging birthday with Jesus. I don't know. Kali, happy birthday to you, first of all. And
happy birthday to you, Kali.
If you had an amazing voice, probably I would have sung for it. Frank, should we try?
Oh, yes, of course. You have an amazing voice, sorry.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Kali.
Oh, yes.
Happy birthday to you. How old are you now?
Oh, yeah. You're going where?
Not plus one, no. But you are a jolly good
fellow. No one dares go there.
Especially with the lady.
No lady ever discloses.
But I've always said I'm 16. I don't know. I'm the only lady who is proud of her age. 16 years old.
I know you don't lie on Christmas Day.
1st of May. Mm-hmm. 2022, I'm going to be 17, yes, and I'll be 18.
I know on Christmas Day you don't lie.
Because I'm sharing the same birthday date with Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Meanwhile, why are you even dragging
birthday? I and Jesus get younger every day.
Oh, really? But I didn't say you were 16. I said I am 16.
You're 16, but I get younger every day.
Oh, so you...
every December, I am Jesus.
I mean, we actually wish you a very, you know, happy birthday. Today, of course, is a special day for you.
Yes, it is.
If anyone has ever seen Tatafu, just, I mean, they should know that Kalista, you know, it's a wonderful presenter. No. You know, how do you feel? Let me just start from there.
Oh, first of all, celebrating the same date, birthday date with Jesus, is wonderful. I feel like I'm the best.
No, you are.
Out for my gigi bread. So I feel 25th has always been a great day for me. Mm. So I remember, my mom never remembers my birthday. She only remembers Merry Christmas, even my dad. So it's always a great day for me. That's all I would say. Nothing. It's more than a great day, but I will use the word great.
Kali, you are an amazing person. I have grown to love you. I've grown to appreciate you. Even in your very annoying times, you are amazing. And I'm glad I met you. And I wish you a happy, happy, happy birthday. If you've not heard it from anybody, I'd like to say this to you. You are a good friend. You are an amazing person. You are loved. We love you and Ibrand. You might be wondering, where is the cake? You don't know the plan we have for you after this show. Oh, Frank.
Well,
in case someone is wondering,
I mean, why Margaret is loving up on Kali. I know that bond. But it's okay. Someone is out there, you're probably wondering, oh, why are we celebrating ourselves like this? We have to celebrate because Ibrand TV, you know, recognizes effort, recognizes we had you know, end of the year party recently. A lot of awards went out and all of that.
Oh, you got an award, you know. In fact, you got an award.
Yes, I did. So right. That's how much we value people in place of our work here. So it's a place where we give opportunities to young people, especially when it comes to, you know, breeding talent or grooming people
for their talent. Our talent here.
Well, it will be the right time to hit the dance floor. Yeah. I want to see you dance because today
it's your birthday.
It's
yesterday's
so,
my day.
Let's go hit the dance
floor. All right.
I'm ready.
All right, for those of you who are also celebrating today, we do not have you off our minds. You're in our hearts, in the deepest part of our hearts. We love you. Wish you a happy, happy, happy birthday celebration. Yes. More years, more life. Fruitfulness, celebrations will never cease in your life. Amen. All right, now it's time to hit straight to the dance floor. Kali is ready to dig it out. Frank is ready to dig it out. And I'm here to dig it in. So,
and more dance people
floor.
Joining
yeah, more people are going to join us, right? So the dance floor, here we go.
Yeah.
Christmas is the season dedicated to everything merry and bright. Between shopping, cooking, and planning all the cocktail parties in between, there is always so much to do in so little time, especially when it comes to shopping for holiday gifts that are unique and thoughtful. In case you're out of gift ideas, I am here to share some with you. Five of them. 1. Food hampers. Tell you what, these are the easiest to get for loved ones. With Christmas in the air, you can be sure to get good deals. Get a hamper with snacks and they will be eating out of that for the rest of the month. Number 2. Electrical appliances, kitchen appliances, or household gadgets. Well, a new phone, a toaster, a new blender, an air conditioning unit, a generator, a rechargeable fan, or an electronic gas cooker is your best deal. 3. Clothes, shoes, and bags. Everyone needs new clothes no matter how rich they are. The important thing is to get your loved one what they like and what they will appreciate. I guess you already know what they will appreciate. And number 4 is perfumes. Now, giving someone perfume is a sign of affection. I mean, if that person doesn't mean so much to you, you shouldn't be considering a perfume as a gift for that person, okay? Well, with beautiful packaging and lovely scents, perfumes signal that the recipient is worth the expense. And at number 5, I'll say get what a person needs. Exactly. I mean, if you're close to this person, you know what this person needs or some things that this person desire. Get any of this for this person, and he or she will be grateful. This is all I have for you. Just 5 of them. Pick anyone you want, and your loved ones will be happy this festive season.
Glad to have you back on Ivan TV Christmas Special Edition. For you, our esteemed viewers, Frank, has been an amazing show so far.
I mean, very interesting show so far, you will say. And I'm sure a lot of people out there would have learned one or two things from the show today on the essence of Christmas. And for those who don't, who are thinking, oh, I do not have food to eat. I mean, from that lesson on the essence of Christmas, of course, they would have come to understand that it's not all about food. It's also about giving out. It's about love, sharing love. And be happy as well.
And be happy. You know, interestingly, it's the end of the year. And as the year wraps up, there's a need to look back and say, I was here before and I'm here today. If not for anything, for the fact that you have oxygen free of charge is enough reason to be thankful this Yuletide season. And do not forget, Christmas is about giving, not just about receiving. So you don't just be on the receiving end. And now the package report, I would say all of the package reports has been a hit back to back to back. That's always a new thing to learn from every of the report. What do you think?
And exactly, and that brought will bring us to where we need to begin to look. Okay, now this year is gone. Of course, very interesting year indeed, you can say, but what is next for me in the coming year? And so you begin to look back. When you look back and where God has brought you from to this point, and you look in the coming year, you expect a whole lot to come up. And I'm looking forward to a brighter new year,
2022,
of course, with all our aspirations, all plans, everything. Just commit your ways to God.
Yeah, and people should also forget that while you are celebrating Christmas, like I always like to say, Christmas is not a time for unnecessary pressure. Do not allow people pressurize you, the society, even your family. Jesus Christ was not born in your village. I like to say that it's the birth celebration of the birth of Jesus and not your birthday. So you don't have to try to overpush yourself to go extra mile, try to please people. Oh, well, that's all I have to say for this edition.
Well, exactly. And this is where we draw the curtain today on iBrand Christmas Special. Of course, earlier we started, in the beginning we started with a one-man band with praise and thanksgiving. I think it's a good time to now dig it on the floor, on the dance floor.
I like the fact you said dig it, and I can't wait for you to dig the gold that's underneath
I'm sure you'll be wondering, oh, I've not seen Frank dance today.
I'll see that.
Wait for it. Wait for it.
The band is waiting for us, or rather, they're standing by, and they are ready to bring us beautiful, beautiful, beautiful music.
And just to add, and a point to bring all our presenters, beautiful faces at iBrand TV. Well, 2022, I will tell you, it's a good year to look forward to. So, all our presenters, it's time to come in now. Let's dance. How about you now? One, man.
Savior, I will praise you, oh my Savior. I will praise you, oh my Savior. I will praise you forevermore. Oh, I will praise you, oh my Savior. I will praise you, oh my Savior. I will praise you, oh my Savior. I will praise you forevermore. Can you sing hallelujah? Jehovah Jireh has done it now. Come on, can you sing hallelujah? Jehovah Jireh has done it well. Come and join me. Come on, can you sing hallelujah? Jehovah Jireh has done it well. Come on, can you sing hallelujah? Jehovah Jireh has done it well.
Hey, only do not me.